Thank you, Tun. That was very enlightening. We have been following your biodata and background and whatnot, but there are some gems that we may have missed in it. Anyway, as I've said, we hope this session to be as interactive as possible. So please do come forward and pass some question that you think that you want Tun to answer.
Assalamualaikum, Tun. First of all, I would like to thank Malaysian Reserve for inviting us. Nama saya Faiz, and I'm from UiTM, and also having a business in clothing. You know, I have two questions for you, Tun. I would like to get some inspiration from how you made your first million. And one more thing is, you know, you look so calm. You, Tun Mahade, I mean, like, I want to know the secret behind, you know, the calmness of whenever you have problems, what comes to your mind on how to solve problems. You know, anak-anak muda sekarang, we retaliate. We voice out concerns. Unlike you guys are so calm. And I just want to know the secrets behind the calmness of individual like you. Thank you.
Nombor satu, ya, the first million memang susah lah to make. Ya. After that, it becomes so easy. It becomes so easy. Now, when we started Maluri, I had no money. And then there were a lot of corruption. It's not easy. I don't know whether you still face corruption today, but I think so. You know? I'm sure, you know, nothing has changed. Yeah, nothing has changed. I needed 600,000, you know, to start the business. And the banks would not lend. The bank would not lend at that time. You know? So the only way to do was to pre-sale. We sold in advance, you know, some of the lot, short lot. You know, they took the money, you know, and then we started the construction. You know, and there was a lot of profit to be made those days. Although we sold houses very cheap. And when I first came to Kuala Lumpur, houses in bungalow houses in in Petang Jaya 18,000. You know. Three-bedroom apartment in Jalan Masjid India, it's called Selangor Mansion, Malaysian Mansion, 6,000. You know? And cars those days cost maximum 6,000. You know? Volkswagen and all those things, 6,000. So to make the first million, as you said, you know, what was that? So we sell those houses in advance first. At a discount, yeah, at a discount, took the money, and that's how the first million came in, you know, yeah. But it was tough, you know, and when we wanted to do end financing, lucky, yeah, these candidates are no longer there, like, you know, some are dead, you know. Every house, the bank wants money, you know. That's corruption at that time. The thing is, I don't know, like, they never realized that one day I was going to be Minister of Finance. And these bankers, you know, and they were there when I became Minister of Finance. You know? So, I mean, it's embarrassing to face these characters who ask money from me. I didn't give. I told my friend, I'm not going to give. I said, Lau, you go and give. I'm not interested in this. You know, Tamichi, you handle this. You know? No way I'm going to give. You know, same with the governor at that time. You know? I don't know whether Kadir remembered. You know? So, Business Time wrote an article, criticized Central Bank. They complained to the Prime Minister, Dr. Mahathir. Mother Mahathir called me. I said, you know, why you criticize the Central Bank? Central Bank is supposed to be perfect. Tahu? Tak boleh buat salah ni. Central Bank kalau buat, wah, you know, marah. So, So I went to see the governor. I went to see the governor. I had to wait outside. So he came. So, what do you want? I said, no, you complained to the Prime Minister about this article. You know, just go and apologize. I have no time. I got a board meeting. 6 months later, I jadi Menteri Kewangan. You know, so it become embarrassment facing. Jadi dalam dunia ni, you must be humble. Tak tahu nasib manusia. Hari ni kita turun, besok kita naik. Jadi kita memang adat. Now, how is it Dr. Mahathir in a crisis is very good. He said, you are very calm. I do not know about him. Me, saya semayang. 5 waktu sehari. Bersyukur kepada Allah. Bersyukur kepada ibu bapa. Itu penting. Yang penting ya, kita semayang lah. Semayang. You be calm. Lepas itu baca Yasin. InsyaAllah. Can always be. Then Allah will always guide you. Because we are Muslims. Okay.
Assalamualaikum. Tun, saya Fizo Omar. Okay. Soalan daripada saya, sekarang ni ramai, terutamanya anak-anak muda, semua nak buat bisnes. Dan bila dah ada bisnes, dah alhamdulillah dah berjaya, sekiranya berjaya anak-anak muda kita ni. Dan ada setengah mereka tu ingin menjadi seorang pemimpin ataupun masuk ke dalam bidang politik. Apa nasihat Tun kepada anak muda kita sekarang ni? Thank you.
Baguslah. Saya memang suka kalau boleh orang Melayu bukan berjaya dalam bisnes tapi juga berjaya dalam politik. Tapi nak berjaya dalam politik kena baca banyak. Kena we must go to other countries, you know. Experience, you know, what's happening in other countries. You know. I visited most of the countries in the world. Most of the countries in the world, you know, I went in China in 1971, try to experience communist punya, you know, style of government gitu, gini. Try to do business also, you know. The Chinese, although they claim, you know, they are communist, you know, equality gitu, gini. Bila I wanted to do business with them, they say no. They said, no, we do business with traditional partners. Cina dengan Cina lah. Tapi dia kena traditional partners. Dengan Melayu dia tak mahu. Yeah? So, you go and see Cuba, for instance. You go and see Africa. You see the hardship. Then you understand. Unless you understand people's hardship, you know, you do not understand how to, in the end, solve the problem. You know, your face, you know. No, I, when I was young, I was a socialist, you know. That is, come on, get a big capitalist. You know? But, you know, to help the poor, you need money. Yeah. I do a lot of charity, you know, in Africa, in Asia, you know. You know? That to do that, you need money. You know? And, you know, and dalam Islam, bila kita mati besok, one thing that Tuhan akan consider is your charitable work. Yeah? Apa yang kita buat. Yeah? Bila mati besok, kita ni tinggal anak yang soleh. Yeah? Yang sembahyang untuk kita. Yeah? Nombor dua, charity. Yeah? Yeah? Nombor empat, ilmu. Yeah? Jadi ilmu ni kita mesti spread dengan ilmu. Ini tiga saja yang tinggal dalam bila mati besok. So, to be a politician, you must have the feelings of the poor. Bukan kaya, yang miskin tu kita nak tolong. There must be equality. The problem dengan Malaysia sekarang, there is inequality. Yeah. Jadi kita berjuang supaya there is equality. Tapi Cina ni semua, dia nak equality cara dia. You know. Kita kata, when we talk in this country, kita must argue, as long as there is inequality, there is injustice. Yeah. Ini yang penting. Tapi bila orang Melayu kaya, dia lupa. Dia lupa daratan. Dia ketepikan apa yang disuruh oleh Allah. One the thing, as I mentioned tadi, is to do charity. Kalau okey lah, orang Islam ni kita smile pun charity. Kalau duduk muka masam, duduk marah ke orang, tak guna je. So, kali sekali smile, that's charity. So, I think, it's good if you have ambition to be successful in business as well as you want to be a politician. But to be what? Politician. Jangan bila jadi politician besok, kita lupa daratan. Ya. Tujuan masuk jadi politik, menolong orang miskin. Ya. So that there is equality among us. When there is equality, there is stability. When stability, there is peace. When there is peace, then they can do business. As long as there is equality, which is at present in Malaysia, the gap is so wide now. Between the poor Malay and the rich Malay, also the gap is wide. Between the Malays and Chinese, it's getting wider. So if you want to go in politics, you must be determined to say that what the rules I want to do is to bring back equality. Yeah, itu yang penting. So I wish you all the best.
Yeah, this one at the back.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Saya Muhammad Afizuddin bin Muhammad daripada Kuching, Sarawak. So, saya masih baru dalam bidang ini sebab saya baru grad bulan 12. Oh, saya masih memang baru. Saya just nak tahu advice. Saya nak advice daripada Tun dan tuan-tuan, puan-puan, bagaimana saya nak hadapi jatuh dia, naik dia dalam bisnes ni, sebab saya belum rasa jatuh bisnes tu macam mana. Saya belum nampak lagi duit tu banyak macam mana. So saya nak tahu macam mana itulah advice pasal bisnes. Baru start bulan 2.
Belum jatuh lah.
Belum.
It's okay lah.
Yang penting lah, what is you want to do? What is you want to do in life? You nak buat apa? Event manager. Event manager. Apa nak cari pemain lawa? I'm not in that line lah. Tapi ada, ada normally event management ni, kena pandai lah. Kena, you want to bring artists, from all the world. You're trying to promote local artists gitu, begini. I'm not in that line. But there's so many who are doing it now. Yeah, so many, So I'm not in position to advise this one. Tanya kawan-kawan lain. Yeah, you tahu, yeah? Yeah? I'm sorry on the line, yeah?
Assalamualaikum, saya Azrinas. First of all, I would like to say thank you, Tun, for sparing some of your time with all of us. I have few question here. Ada sesetengah pihak mendakwa tindakan kerajaan dengan pemberian BRIM yang mendakwa ia bukanlah satu tindakan wajar ataupun bijak sehingga menyebabkan bebanan kepada kewangan kerajaan. So, Tun sebagai satu ikon yang berpengalaman dalam ni, what do you say about this? Yang kini kita nampak bebanan kerajaan semakin tinggi. And my second question, you were saying that you were telling the truth to rakyat when we had this recession, that we were in a mess at that time. So looking at our political and economy situation now, do you think that we are in a mess now?
Yeah, ini BRIM ni. BRIM ni nombor satu yang tak setuju Dr. Mahathir lah, ya. Dia tak setuju. Yang kata saya tak setuju, Dr. Mahathir tak setuju. But you know, as a policy, I think it's a bad policy. Yeah. On one hand, yeah, you kata everything is okay. And kalau everything is okay, then you don't need the support, kan? Yeah, yeah. Number satu, you say you want to reduce this subsidy mentality ni. Tadi kalau you bagi duit ni, subsidi lah tu. Yeah. And the worst part, yang kerjaan lupa, you know, I have been saying this. Because when you give this BRIM to everybody, you know, then UMNO pun dapat, PAS pun dapat, DAP pun dapat, you know, and apa keadilan pun dapat. Orang UMNO, dia ambil duit, dia gunalah. Orang PAS, dia ambil duit, setengah dia bagi balik ke parti. DAP pun begitu juga, dia ambil half, setengah dia bagi parti. Jadi dia kata terima kasih lah. Jadi parti, you finance parti to fight you. Kan? Tak ke bodoh kan? So, this is what happened masa Haris was chief minister in Sabah. You know? Dia ingat nak menang election, dia bagi huge dividend. Dalam amanah apa, amanah Sabah ke apa gitu. Kini, you know? So Kandazan ambil duit tu bagi kat Kandazan, you know, to fight Haris. Haris kalah election lah. They say thank you so much for giving the money. We don't have to raise fund. You give us the money, you know, you give us 6 billion. If 3 billion goes to the opposition, you finance them lah. Terima kasih lah. You kalah election, ha. Tengangah lah. So this is not a good policy, BRIM ni, you know. But no, there are other ways. What do rakyat wants is employment. Yeah. Kalau semua ada kerja, tak perlu BRIM lah. Yeah. Dia nak tahu inflation tinggi pasal apa. Barang naik ni, turun harga. Dia kata GST, dia sebut kan, pergi satu negara, masih television GST, GST, GST. Rakyat bukan nak tahu, dia tak peduli GST ni, dia nak tahu harga naik tak. Yeah. Kalau bagi pengakuan harga tak naik, okey lah. Bila cerita GST, cerita no cerita, rakyat not interested. Dia nak tahu harga naik tak? Barang tak naik, okey. Alhamdulillah. Yeah, itu yang penting. As simple as that. Dasar, itu sebab. Communication with rakyat is very important. Kalau dasar bagus, tak tahu explain, orang exploit lah. So BRIM is one. Now whether we are in crisis, the Prime Minister said we are not in crisis. So kita terima lah apa Perdana Menteri kata. But the real issue is people tanya sekarang pasal harga naik, kan? Orang rakyat nak tahu pasal apa harga naik. Pasal apa ringgit jatuh, rakyat nak tahu juga. Yeah. Go and explain lah benda-benda. Semalam governor kata kan, governor came semalam kata it's not fair for rating agency to downgrade. The ringgit is undervalued. Dia kata begitu. But the newspaper tak tanya. If you say the fundamentals are good, mengapakah ringgit goes down? What do you think? Why the ringgit goes down? Can anybody answer? Yeah? Eh? We are in crisis. No. The ringgit goes down because people have no confidence in the country. Itu saja. There's nothing wrong with the ringgit, but people have no faith in this country, Mojaga, no confidence. If everything is okay, the ringgit must not go down. So there must be a reason. The reason is people have no confidence. People tak percaya dekat kerjaan. That's the reason. But the, because kita polite, kita tak tanyalah. Kita biarlah, kata fundamental bagus. So, kalau semua bagus, semua baik, no crisis gitu, gini, why must the ringgit go down? You know, tak ada sebab. Jadi, masa saya jadi Menteri Kewangan, orang percaya dekat saya. Waktu UMNO tak percaya, rakyat percaya. Kenapa? Because, nombor satu, I was a successful businessman. I have been successful. Because if I say something, they say, trust him. Yeah. Even in a crisis, they trust me. Itu penting. Yeah. Jadi kita mesti orang percaya kepada diri kita. Sebagai pengusi kata tadi, saya, I think I am better than the Chinese. Because I believe in myself that I'm better than the Chinese. And I think I can take on anybody in business because I believe I'm better. Itu yang penting. Percaya pada diri dulu. Like, you know, in life, sebab saya kata the first time I retire, I was silly. For silly reason. I wanted to be rich. I was rich. I should, in life, I should be, and all of you must be, you want to be successful. Yang penting, with success, you can make money. Yeah? If you are successful, tennis player, like Federer, you'll make money. Yeah? Feel that? Successful a footballer like Messi, you are going to make money. Success must come first. You know, whatever you want to do, make sure you are successful. Don't be silly like me, retire because I want to be rich. Jangan. I must be successful, then people will recognize me. Yeah. So I want you all to be successful in life so that people say, that's the man I want to be.
Assalamualaikum, Tun. Saya Muhammad Sufian Azim, saya student Uni KL. Saya nak tanya mengenai perbankan dan kewangan sedikit. Comes in my concern when digital currency becoming the new pink in the industry. So apa yang Tun rasa yang digital currency ni boleh lakukanlah untuk bisnes kita ataupun in for our country. Itu saja. Digital currency such as Bitcoin.
Oh, okay. This is new, yeah. And you know, it started in England. It started in England. Yeah. No, I'm not familiar with this. You know, I don't want to comment something I do not know. Yeah. I'm so sorry. Yeah, on this.
Assalamualaikum, Tun. Nama saya Syed Muhammad Gaddafi. Saya seorang pengusaha.
Saya pernah Libya.
Saya Muhammad Gaddafi Syed Ali. Saya adalah salah seorang pengusaha di KL. And alhamdulillah produk saya berjalan dengan baik. Cuma sekarang ni saya banyak bagi talk dan ada ura-ura mengatakan yang bahawasanya ekonomi kita menurun. So yang saya lihat sekarang adalah orang kita, saya panggil orang kita lah, sebab mentaliti dia orang berfikiran nak berjaya, nak kaya adalah dengan membuat produk. So pada saya, tak tahu betul atau tidak, kreativiti boleh membuat kita berjaya tapi bukan buat produk. Sebab bila saya kadang-kadang pergi event apa semua, saya tengok ada askar pencen, polis pencen, they like to invest, like buat produk, tapi at the end of the day dia tak boleh nak buat jualan. So sekarang ni saya banyak bagi talk untuk nak alihkan perhatian orang supaya kena cari keunikan diri, kena cari apa yang dia minat untuk berjaya. Sebab sekarang ni siapa-siapa makcik kampung pun nak buat produk. So kita nak membantu orang-orang Malaysia supaya jangan miskin di bumi sendiri. Tapi macam mana nak alihkan perhatian ni supaya cari kreativiti tu? Dan soalan saya, adakah kerana masing-masing sibuk buat produk yang sama ni akan menjatuhkan ekonomi kita di Malaysia?
Dia no, normally nak buat produk ni you must do market study dulu. You cannot just go and produce anything you like, you know. Jadi orang Melayu ni, tapi ingat orang Melayu, kalau seorang jual goreng pisang, semua nak jual goreng pisang. You know, you go to Chowkat sekarang, you go to Chowkat orang Indonesia, all selling the same thing. Ya, yeah, betul ya. You pergi Pekan Rebu, Walostak, orang Melayu jual all the same thing, you know. Jadi macam mana nak compete? It's too many, you know. You only succeed in life if you do something unique. You know, you know, it's, when it's too common, then nobody wants, nobody interested, you know. Kalau perempuan yang lawa semua orang mau, yang tak lawa tak ada lah. It's nature is like that. So you have to do your market study and make sure that that's the demand. You see, let me tell you something. Number satu yang, if you want to be really successful, number satu, pakaian orang semua nak pakai. Yeah, tapi which type of pakaian? Makanan orang makan, tapi which type of makanan? You know, yeah, yeah. Housing, oh mesti orang nak duduk. So these are sectors. If you go in, the chances are you will succeed. You know, okay, sekarang as you say, perempuan suka make up begitu begini. You know, Siti ni buat Simplicity, Guardiano buat dan macam-macam. Everybody in the end, there's so much. You know, that can you market or not? If you cannot market, you're going to fail. You know. Sekarang di Malaysia, kalau buat tudung, laku. Yeah, the market is no 2 billion. Orang Melayu semua pakai tudung, dulu tak pakai tudung. So you go in tudung, you know, do, I don't know how you market it, but you know, it's 2 billion worth. You know, it masuk Indonesia lagi besar. You know, so that's a huge market just on tudung. You know, but you have to do market study first. Tengok, in the end, that's what the design begitu, begini semua. You know, to be successful. But you don't try to rush into it, and as you say, orang kampung mau nak buat ni. Ramai semua. You know, we have to make sure bila tekun ke apa bagi nak bagi pinjaman PMB punya, make sure that you know there's a market for all this thing. Not because you know, everybody wants to go in thinking that you know they can succeed. But in the end, I said you know when you want to sell something, it's the quality that count. You know? Macam Jepun dia buat tu, is, their quality is better than us. You know, you see, kita tengok goreng pisang. I give you example goreng pisang. In Penang, orang Melayu punya tak laku. Cina punya laku. Because they make sure that pisang tu pisang masak betul. Orang Melayu pisang tak masak pun dia goreng. Dia pergi jual. You know? So, bila orang taste, eh, ni apa ni? So people pay for quality. So in the end, people queue China. Eh? You know? So it's a quality that count. You know? Jepun punya quality is again. You know, after the war, the German became successful. Yeah? After the German, it was Japanese who became successful. You know? After the Japanese, you know, it was the they call the Tigers. The Tigers. Maybe in Korea, Taiwan, Singapore, and Hong Kong. You know? And after that, of course, China. Now China. Now, from today, if you look at, you know, because China, the cost has gone up. So the odds are India, Indonesia, Brazil. You know, they are going to be the next Tigers. You know, Malaysia is not in the picture. Very strange. Nombor satu, I don't know, maybe kita too complacent, kita malas, you know, thinking that, you know, we can live, eh? Kita ada oil, eh? Kita ada rubber, kita ada palm oil, as if these industries will carry us through the next wave of, you know, the tigers, you know. So we have to be careful, we have to come up with new industries, you know. I cannot think of a new industry for Malaysia at that time because our education system is not good enough. You know, we have to change our education system, you know. We must produce more engineers. Instead, we produce too many lawyers. So kita bergaduh sama-sama sendiri. Everybody goes to court, you know. We have produced more scientists, you know, to take our country to the next stage. So I hope I have answered your question. Yeah. Yeah. And then again.